In the days not too far from now, we will all have to make one choice: to bow down to the living God or to bow down to the image of the beast. And please do not think it won't take place in your lifetime. Don't think. The way things are moving so fast now, I promise you and I guarantee you, it will take place in your lifetime. That means, that shows how imminent the end times are. It's not something far away in the future. It's now right outside the doorstep. That's how close we are. And I tell you one thing. The coronavirus, COVID-19, is a judgment of God. However, the powers to be, now there are two kinds of powers to be. One is the God kind. The other is the evil kind. So the evil kind is capitalizing on the situation to put into implementation their future plan for world domination. Now you see all that happening in the world right now. How much the population are controlled. Lockdown. Don't go out. Virus flying everywhere. So what do? Stay at home. Don't go out. Virus flying everywhere. So one day I asked someone, you know, so virus flying everywhere and you stay at home, doesn't the virus come into your house? How come the virus doesn't come into your house? Don't you keep the windows open? Do you or do you not? Okay, if you do, doesn't the virus know how to come through the window into your house? Is there an invisible barrier that the virus can see with its spiritual eyes? That, okay, this is a person's house, let's not come in. Let's stay outside and wait for our victim to come out. Okay. They say put on a face mask for our own good. All right, we obey. And then they said, okay, when can you take it off? When you are eating. So I asked once a restaurant a question. So when I remove the mask when I'm eating, doesn't the virus come in? Right? Doesn't the virus, okay, oh, the virus knows. Oh, they are eating, let's stay outside. You see how ridiculous the whole thing is?
Yes.
Yet, then why do they do that? A practice, don't say control, practice towards global domination. This is a practice, a trial that's going on. The powers to be, the anti-powers, it's a dry run for them. Okay, now they have come up with a new thing. The new thing is, oh, we should eliminate cash, currency, because you are handling the currency, the virus can stay on the paper. It stays on the paper, and then when you share the note to someone else, the virus sticks on the paper like the Aladdin on the magic carpet. You know Aladdin on the magic carpet, right? Okay. So just like that, the virus stays on and it flies from this person to the next person. Once you touch the note, it jumps on you. So, how to solve this problem? Let's go cashless. You see? That is another step towards the mark of the beast. No buying, no selling. Let's do everything online. Online. See, that is the ultimate plan of the Antichrist. See, it will never come all of a sudden. It's inch by inch, inch by inch, so that it be so stealthily, so subtle, that almost all of us will fall for it. Because we are psycho-conditioned to think this is better. This is better. Right? So, the virus travels on your banknote. Okay, eliminate cash. Let's use credit card. Okay? Plastic. Virus doesn't stay on plastic. Okay? But that's only for temporary. Then a few months later, they'll say, oh, we have just discovered that plastic attracts the virus more than the paper. So let's eliminate plastic. You know, presently, many nations in the world are eliminating plastic. They don't use plastics anymore. Credit cards are made of plastic, right? So they'll say, okay, let's save Mother Earth. We must save Mother Earth. Have you noticed there is a great awareness of climate control, climate change today? Where is that going to lead to? Ah, climate pollution, air pollution, plastic. Let's get rid of plastics. So when you get rid of plastics, what is the next step? The most convenient. Let's do everything online. Get rid of coins. And when what are they introducing? Bitcoin. Cryptocurrency. Have you heard of all this? Yeah. Ah, Bitcoin. Cryptocurrency. You don't see them, but they exist in the virtual world. So they are going to go back to the old system of bartering. You use your cryptocurrency, Bitcoins, to buy and to sell. So, now, so eliminate all this. So, again, your identity can be stolen. Right? Identity can be stolen. So, what to do? Because if you put a thumbprint, they can take a thumb impression and steal your thumbprint. So, what to do? So, they came up with a clever plan. All right. We'll do something else. Instead of thumbprint, let's scan the veins in your palm. Science fiction has become reality today. You know, this Amazon have put on trial a machine that you just put your palm above it. The scanner will scan your veins and then register you. When you enter into the store, you scan your palm. And then when you take out all your goods, and when you want to leave the store, no need to pay money, no credit card, nothing. Just scan your palm again. All your money is deducted. Isn't it wonderful? You see? Very convenient, right? Don't need to carry a thick wallet anymore. All plastic cards down the drain. Eliminate all of them. Just your one hand is enough. So what happens if someone is amputated? John, what to do with that? Leg. Good idea. You see, where is this leading to? The mark of the beast. Inch by inch by inch is leading towards that. So there will be two options before us. To worship the image of the beast or to worship the true living God. And what is the one thing, one attribute in the center that will make you to yield to this or yield to that? Obedience. To whom will you obey? Will you obey the system of this world? Or will you obey the living God, no matter even if it causes your life? This is where most Christians are going to fall. When it comes to make a choice between your life, either you live for the devil or you die for God, which will you choose? If I ask you this question, all of you will put up your hand and say, yes, I will give my life to the Lord. No problem. But what about your babies? If it is between your baby and you, what will you do, Brittany? I mean, the life of your baby or to worship the Antichrist? Which will you choose? So, oh, you already prepared. Very good. So you don't mind your baby's been, their head's been dashed against the stone. You don't mind. Huh?
I would mind,
but you don't care. You know, I asked my staff this question. In our staff meeting, I'll tell you this story, okay? In our staff meeting, I asked everyone this question. So they all said, yes, we'll give our life to God. So there was one of my staff who just delivered a new baby. So I asked her, she said, tell me, my dear daughter, if they just squeeze the neck of your newborn baby, how would you feel? Earlier on, she was very bold to answer, you know. But when I presented this picture, she was quiet. And then I said, they squeeze harder, and you can hear the scream of your baby. What will you do? Tears started rolling down her eyes. She had no answer, which is the normal reaction of a mother. Normal reaction. But like what Brittany has answered, we must prepare our children to be martyrs for the Lord. You must prepare. It is written in the scriptures that such a scenario that I just painted is not a fiction. It will come to pass in the future because such a scenario had taken place in the past. They have taken up little children, babies, and just dashed their head against the stone, against the wall. You will find this in the book of 2 Kings. This has happened in the past, and there is a prophecy in the book of Amos that it will happen again in the future. We are vulnerable at our weakest point. So you want to strengthen even the weakest link in your life and in your family. You must be mentally prepared that death is just temporary. It's just a temporary loss. Eventually, we'll all be united together. It's just a temporary loss. So until and unless you are not mentally strong and prepared in the spirit and in your faith of such things, then when it comes to a choice, we will fall. No matter what happens, you and your spouse and your children must make a decision. Like how Joshua made a decision. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We will not bow down to any other gods.